CAT-17 was conducted at various centers across the nation. And we have with us Mr. Ankur Jain and Mr. Pradeep Pandey from T.I.M.E. expert to have the detailed analysis of the exam. So what's your take on CAT-17 question paper?
The paper was as declared by the IIMS, it was an examination with three sections. The first section was the verbal ability and reading comprehension, the VARC section. It was for 1 hour and it had 34 questions. The second section was the DILR section, data interpretation and logical reasoning section, and it had 32 questions. And the final section was the quant section, quantitative aptitude section. It had 34 questions. So in all, the examination had 100 questions, and each question carried 3 marks for the correct answer. There were a total of 26 questions without negative marking, and they were therefore did not attract any negative marking, as I just explained. So for wrong answer or for no attempt, you got 0 there. But for the questions with the negative marking, there was a scope of -1 for wrong answer. For no attempts, it was 0. So that is the broad structure of the examination. It was a paper very, very similar. There were some minor differences, but it was very similar to the CAT 2016 and the CAT 2015 papers. That is the broad structure of the examination.
What was the difficult level of the paper, if you could discuss with us?
It's very difficult to comment on it so early. However, whatever we have understood from speaking to students after the first slot as well as the second slot is that the examination of English was in general on the easier side compared to last year's examination. The other two sections, I'm sure Pradeep sir can explain better. Mm-hmm.
So if I speak about LDA sections, the number of questions were 32, comprised of 8 set, and each set had 4 questions. And the level of difficulty was higher than that of the CAT 2016. And the student who had appeared in both the CAT 2016 and 2017 are saying that the cutoff scores should be at par with CAT 2016. But my own gut feeling is, it could be lower than that of the CAT 2016. So the difficulty level was very, very high. Most of the questions were difficult. Few questions were difficult plus. So, and we can definitely say that most of the students faced lots of challenge in DILR sections. And clearly, the difficulty level was not that they had anticipated.
So, quant section.
Yeah. And so basically, students find DILR section very difficult. So, your take on that?
As I earlier said, the cutoff score for at least one IIM course should be at par with CAT 2016, but it could be lower also. So as time progresses, after 1 or 2 days, we can clearly figure out how much score is required to get cutoff score for IIMs.
So, talking about the paper pattern, CAT 17 was similar to CAT 16.
Yes, it was. If I look at the examination specifically within English section, the English section had 5 RC passages. There were 3 RC passages with 6 questions each, and there were 2 RC passages with 3 questions each. So a total of 24 questions, which was the same as CAT 15 and CAT 16. Additionally, there were 10 VA questions, verbal ability questions, and the breakup was very similar. There were in some students reported 5 para jumbles, some said 4 were there, some even said there were 3, but that was a very rare number. Most people then reported some summary writing questions and odd man out para jumble questions. The difficulty level, as we discussed earlier, was marginally lower, so the cutoff should be marginally higher. That was the structure of the examination. However, there was one minor difference in this. Last year in the English section, All the 10 questions of VA were without negative marking. But this year, only 7 out of 34 were without negative marking instead of 10 last year. So what it means is that 3 additional questions had negative marking in the English section. However, that was kind of compensated by the increase in the questions without negative marking in by one in the LRDI section and by three in the quant section. So overall, last year the questions without negative marking were 25, and that was the same thing even last year. This year it is 26. So there is a bit of a difference in the overall difficulty level of the paper also. As far as the structure of the paper in the other two parts is concerned, I'm sure Pradeep sir can answer that better.
So if I go with the quant section, students are saying that quant paper was very, very easy, and the proportion of arithmetic question was very high. So that must be, you can say, the good news for those students who are from non-engineering background. So engineers might be not very happy with the level of difficulty, because they had anticipated some higher difficulty level paper. But my finger is crossed. Most of the students are saying ki I had attempted 25 questions, 28 questions, 30 questions. Some of the students are saying I have attempted all 34 questions. But my own guess is the accuracy percentage will play the crucial role in percentile score. So cutoff score is concerned, my own guess is it should be higher than that of the CAT 2016.
So according to some students, there were many arithmetic questions in the morning slots.
Yes.
So your take on that?
So arithmetic, the proportion of arithmetic question was you can say more than 50% of the paper, but students were saying that there were so many questions in which answer options were very, very close, or some questions were non-MCQ question or TETA question in which students were very confused whether my answer is right or wrong. And students also reported that in few questions they thought that I'm supposed to give the answer in terms of kilometer, but actually question was the answer is in terms of meter. So my suggestion to those students who are thinking of higher percentile score in quant, they should also consider the accuracy level if they give some more amount of time on analysis of the paper. They will find some more questions in which they had committed some silly errors.
Okay. So, will you give a section-wise analysis of the paper?
Okay. As far as the English section is concerned, I've already discussed the broad structure of the paper. Compared to last year, it was felt that RC topics were quite easy. They were very similar to last year's paper, students felt. And most of the passages were very readable, except for maybe one passage in both the slots, one passage each in the two slots. The remaining four passages were found to be quite readable and understandable. Additionally, the questions, as reported by the students, indicate not very difficult questions. There were hardly any questions which can be considered as very difficult. Perhaps not even a single question of the English section was very difficult. Last year what had happened was that there were quite a few misleading questions because answer choices were very close, but this year that proportion has gone down. So therefore paper might be easier than last year is the difficulty level analysis as far as we can say. Last year the cutoff for a single IIM call, that is what we consider, was around 41 marks plus minus 1 marks. This was CAT 2016 cutoff. So it is expected that cutoff will rise. Now how much will it rise, we really cannot say. It's very difficult to do it unless we speak to a large number of students. But yes, as we have been saying earlier, our gut feel, our instinct is that it should climb somewhat. So from that perspective, I think students who have done the MCATs well, who have analyzed their mocks well, they would have found that analysis of close options and answer choices which are very similarly written, the MCATs would have helped those students a lot. Plus the revision on student homepage, the sectional tests, etc., would have definitely benefited the students. That is the right way to prepare. We've been saying this throughout the year, and as expected, the paper is along those lines only. That is what is the primary point behind the difficulty level, the cutoffs, of the examination. As far as the other two sections are concerned, I'm sure Pradeep sir has already mentioned somewhat, but I'm sure the detailed analysis perhaps might be in order here.
Yes. In LRDA section, questions appears to be very easy. Some of the sets appears to be very easy, and a student tempted to attempt the set. But after investing some time, they realize that I fell into the trap.
In fact, so the word used by one student was the word quicksand. Aisa lag raha hai daldal mein phas gaye, jitna struggle kar rahe utna hi gir rahe.
This is
what a lot of students have said, that it was very tricky in many cases.
So LRDA section was very, very tricky, and normally a student scan the whole paper and try to segregate the doable sets. But I'm sure even the brightest student have shortlisted few, you can say, those set in which they later on find that no, this is not the right question that I should attempt for. For quant section, I must say accuracy is the key, and most of the questions were easy or moderate, barring one or two questions that can be kept in the category of moderate plus. But one of the students told me just 30 minutes back that I had attempted some 28 questions, but I realized that I have committed some silly mistake in 5 or 6 questions. I'm sure other student must have the similar story. So accuracy is definitely the key element in quant section, and cutoffs should be definitely higher than that of the CAT 2016.
So, like as we have already discussed the cutoff, what students should do now?
I think there are multiple things a student could do now. One thing is that students should look at the analysis on our website and try to understand how well they have done, because many forms of B schools are still open, and they may want to apply, they may not want to apply. I would always advise students to err on the side of caution, that is to err on the side of applying the form, as in if you are unsure whether I should apply or not, they should apply, because that is just some money. But if they don't apply and realize later that they could have gotten a call, that would be more disastrous. So it is better to spend some extra money and invest in forms based on their preparation and their performance. Additionally, other things that they can do in the meanwhile is that they should not stop studying if they have had a bad CAT. Other exams are very important. Just next week you have the IFT paper, and then 2 weeks or 3 weeks after that you have the SNAP paper, and then 1.5 months from now you have the ZAT paper. So preparation for all of them is very similar, in the sense that there is a GK in all the three examinations, and students' focus on GK should be much stronger now. That would be the other point I would like to make. Additionally, GK will help them in preparation for the GDPI, the other part after the CAT exam results are available. So it is a very good idea that they don't give up right now. I have, in my past experience as a faculty member and motivator for students, I've seen a very large number of candidates don't do well in CAT. There are lots of reasons for that. They were not prepared, they were taken aback by the difficulty level in one section. There are students who come today also and said that I could have done very well in quant, but because LRDI broke my confidence, I could also not do even well in the quant section which was after it. So that can really damage their chances in the examination. But in the past I have seen that students who don't give up right now and just get up, dust off the clothes and move further to the next exam are the ones who succeed. I have seen a very large number of candidates who do badly in CAT and then do very well in ZAT and get excellent calls and convert those calls. So they should not ignore other examinations. Even if you had a bad exam, just keep your chin up and go to the next exam. That is what I would advise you.
So it seems like CAT 17 was a mixed question paper.
Absolutely.
Is it so?
Absolutely, because in our opinion, the two sections, VARC and Quant, are easier than last year, whereas the LRDI is, let's say, tougher than last year. So in that case, if something becomes easier, something becomes tougher, it's a mixed bag. And therefore, judging the overall cutoff is not so easy. However, if I look at simply the fact that two of them have become easier, one has become tougher, it's likely that the cutoff is slightly higher even overall. That is what we can say here.
Yes. One more thing, a student not feel disheartened with the number of attempt of LRDE section.
Yes.
It might be possible if they will get the unexpected score in LRDE section, despite of low attempt. Yes, or on the other way around, in quant section, might be they anticipated some 99 percentile score or 99.5 percentile score. So it is means I'm not sure how much they are correct only by going with the number of attempt in the quant section. So we can't say anything about quant section because question paper was very, very easy. In easy paper, it is very difficult to predict anything, right? But in LRDE section, I'm sure they are going to get unexpected score.
Okay. So today at Kalkati Test Center, the server were down and like students have asked to move to other centers. And is this the part, like this shows the negligence of IIM somehow?
I would not like to comment on the IIMs here because it's frankly an internal matter of theirs. However, as far as it affects the students, I think it's a very serious issue whatever happened. We as an organization believe that the IIMs are the best authority to speak on the matter. Speaking on behalf of the larger student community, I would like to say that how the matter was handled was perhaps not very professional initially, but yes, clearly later on the authorities have moved the students to other centers. We have heard that some students were taken to Noida and some to Greater Noida. So I believe that as long as students are able to write the examination properly and in the proper frame of mind, then I think it's the best for them. If there are issues here this year with one center students not being able to write for some various issues, and then whatever we understand is that perhaps some miscommunication was also there to the students that servers are down across the country, something like that we were told. So I really don't understand how this can be done. I mean, perhaps better arrangements could have been made as a backup plan.
Yes.
But yes, as long as students are able to write the exam properly in the proper frame of mind, I think it is the best for everybody. That is what I'd like to say.
Thank you. So do we have any questions? Okay. So we hope that all your queries has been answered. So and for more updates, you can visit India Today Education Facebook page. This is Marika Pant signing off with Apurva Anand from India Today Education.